A lot of fierceness, a lot of ferocity, a lot of hype, a lot of glam, a lot of glitz. Nothing but queer POC energy, really.
I don't need to prove anything to you. This is me, and you're gonna see it.
You would never feel energy like what you do at the balls anywhere else. That's the power of Ballroom. I just want to welcome Chris and Bailey into the stage. Thank you for coming through. My name is Eleganza. I am 33 years of age. I am a femme queen, trans woman of colour.
Ballroom originated in New York's underground scene in the 60s, pioneered by African-American and Latinx trans women. Their elaborate moves, called voguing, were often a commentary on race, class and gender.
It was created out of the prejudice, you know, reaction of feeling misjudged and of racism. So voguing is our political stance. On the floor! Now, today, we call that old way. Now, the style of voguing has revolutionized. Let's go! Yes, yes! And the style is called Vogue Femme, and that's when we see all the fluidity, and we have different elements of this art form and this dance form, and it's not just the voguing. We have categories such as face, and it's all about celebrating your face, and do you have a beautiful face? We also have categories like realness. So as a trans woman, could she walk out in the real world and no one would budge? She looks like a cis woman. We also have categories like runway, and runway is all about, can you walk? Do you have the best walk? Sex siren, which is, you know, your body and how can you sell the essence of sex? And then we have commentator versus commentator, and that's the people on the mic, they're versing one another. So there's so many different categories.
The ballroom scene is said to have migrated to Australia in 2014 and has been growing in popularity ever since. Those in the scene belong to groups called houses, and here in Meanjin, Brisbane, Ella and 20 others are part of the House of Alexander.
These houses serve as like surrogate families, chosen families. We have a mother and a father, and then we have children.
Okay, let's go.
Ella is the mother of the house. First Nations man Joshua Taliani is the father.
My role is just helping be a leader, helping shape them to grow in today's society as much as possible, and just being a support system for them, really.
For Ella, the journey to start the house has been a challenging one.
I've definitely experienced my fair share of judgment. Oh, my God, I don't want to get emotional. Early transition was very hard. You want to live in your most authentic self and you want to be seen for who you are. And it's hard when your family don't see that, or I guess support it, because being a Samoan, Maori, Pacific person, you know, our upbringing and our cultural values teach us everything that goes against who I am as a person.
Ella's family have come to accept and support the woman she is, and now she's helping the young trans women of the house, some of whom have faced rejection, violence, and even homelessness.
I did experience domestic violence, you know, a lot of harm, a lot of us grew up being a Polynesian, being religious. It just didn't fit well with anyone.
I started like socially transitioning very young. I would say like 14. When I graduated high school, I was kicked out of home. And then when I turned 18 and started my hormone replacement therapy, that was kind of like the final straw for my family.
For many, the House of Alexander has become a second family.
For me, oh, sorry, I might get emotional. For me, like, the house is literally my saving grace. I had nobody else but myself before I met these guys.
A lot of people would look at us and think of us as a dance crew or think of us as a collective, but we're a family before anything.
I teach my trans women of colour, my daughters specifically, on how to hold yourself with a job interview, access to medical health with hormone replacement therapy, teaching them how to deal with discrimination. Sometimes family always is in blood. And I think the Alexander family and the Alexander House is definitely a testament to that.
Several times a year, houses from around Australia compete at a ball event. Last weekend, Alexander House hosted one of the biggest balls to date, with people coming from around Australia and New Zealand.
It's our red carpet moment, it's our Olympics, and it's where we just get to strut our stuff.
Really quickly, I love you all so much, and we've all worked our asses off to get here. This is so much more than just a house to us. What did we say? What are we first?
Family.
Family for it all. So, you know, do what you need to do. Let's just be boring, yeah?
Ali!
We want some butch queens. We want some butch queens.
It's seeing people who are so used to being ostracized and marginalized in the everyday world, seeing that liberation that they feel when they walk up on this stage, seeing them be so powerful just by themselves.
When you go on that journey with someone who shares a similar experience, you're able to carry the burden together. And I think that's the power of ballroom, is that, you know, we are no longer walking alone.
Women like me now, we're reclaiming space and we're in the middle, at the center of the narrative bit.